know, God has given you immense, tremendous potential to achieve everything. Whatever you thought you can achieve. The only thing is that you have to see exactly whether you are seeing the brightness of life or seeing the darkness of life. For example, I want to say a human being, if you are seeing his back, for example, the back is showing the badness qualities of that particular person. But from front side is showing you the goodness qualities. And imagine that just you are walking on a line, you are standing on a queue. If you are seeing the back side, that means you are seeing the dark side or the bad qualities of that particular person, then you are standing at the back of him. But if you are seeing the goodness qualities of that particular person, then you are standing at the in front of him. Now you have to decide exactly, where do you want to stand, in front of or at the back? So it is, the thing is that, so you have to see the positive things from that particular person if you want to go ahead of him. Otherwise, you are going to be behind him. You are going to stand behind him and you are not going to get that target. So always think the positive parts of the thing. The main problem with us is that we are just seeing the negative parts of that particular person and we are just missing the original picture of that person also. What are the best things, what are the good things in him or her? Because of our negative attitude, our mind has become so sophisticated that we are not able to see the bright path of that particular person. Three men were just putting bricks and making a beautiful building. A man passed there and asked the question one by one. He asked, "Sir, what are you doing?" The first man replied, "Don't you see? I am putting up the bricks and earning money." The man went to the second man. He asked again the same question, "Sir, what are you doing?" He said, "Don't you see? I am earning wages. I am putting bricks." Again, the person went to the third person and asked, "Sir, what are you doing?" The third person replied, "Sir, I am making a beautiful building where people are going to live in a very happier and merrier life." See, same work, three different people, three different answers. So what an attitude. This is called as a difference between negative and positive attitude. So if you have to be positive, that third person was a little bit positive. That's why he gave an answer like different, that he was just loving his work. It shows that if your attitude is positive, then you love your work. You will never get tired from this attitude. If you are positive, then you are going to, you cannot get tired, you cannot bored from your work. But people with negative attitude are giving the answer different. You see three people, same work, three different answers. That means a person working in the same atmosphere can have a different attitude. One person, both the answers were different, and the third one was in a positive attitude because he was loving his work. In the same way, just I want to request you that you have to love your work if you want to attain success in life. You have to be positive in your positive, you have to use your positive attitude in each and every sphere of life. Did you imagine? A good teacher can be a very good teacher without positive attitude. Or a good parents can be good parents. A good student can be a good student. A good political leader can be a good political leader without positive attitude. That means positive attitude is going to make a very good role play in each and every sphere of life. So friends, always be serious while selecting your attitude. If you are going to be in a positive attitude, a whole country is going to love you. But if you are having a very good quality but accepting the attitude, the problem, so you cannot get love from your public. So always be positive and have a very positive attitude.